Praise the Lord. Welcome everyone to another episode of the Journey Through Apostolic Successions. The Catechism of the Catholic Church, paragraph 100 states, "The task of interpreting the Word of God authentically has been entrusted solely to the Magisterium of the Church, that is, to the Pope and to the bishops in communion with him." So today, let us hear about our 47th Pope in Apostolic Succession. Pope Simplicius served as the Pope for 15 years, from the year of 468 AD until his death in 483. Living in a period of great turmoil that saw the collapse of the Roman Empire. In the time of his pontificate, the long-lasting Western Roman Empire finally ended in a period of chaos. Let us look into some of the interesting facts now. Pope Simplicius' successor was Pope Felix III. When his predecessor, Pope Hilarius, died, the Church chose Simplicius to be the new Pope and had him consecrated only 10 days later, on February 25th of 468 AD. Now, some of the contributions he made to the Church. Pope Simplicius fought heresy, expanded the consecration of bishops to months other than only December, and attempted to be the counterbalance to the chaos of Germanic barbarian invasions. Simplicius convened his own synod in Rome in the year 478 AD, in which he declared anathemas against bishops in the East who practiced heresy, including John of Apamea, Peter Fullo, and Paul of Ephesus. Pope Simplicius also oversaw a building program during his pontificate. He receives credit for the Santa Bibiana Church, built in memory of Saint Bibiana, a martyr. Dedicated a new church called Church of Saint Stefano Rotondo, as well as one on the Camp Verano, which was dedicated to Saint Lawrence, and another church of Saint Andrea. Pope Simplicius made it a personal mission to help the people of Rome to navigate through those dark and dangerous times. When the barbarian Odoacer became king of Italy in place of the last Roman emperor Romulus Augustulus, Simplicius remained in effective command in the city of Rome. Pope Simplicius fought to uphold the Chalcedonian Orthodoxy while he opposed the ecclesiastical policies of Eastern Roman Emperor Zeno. The Church celebrates his feast day. Pope Simplicius was laid to rest when he died of old age in St. Peter's Basilica on the 10th of March in 483 AD. After his death, Pope Simplicius became a saint with a feast day on March 10th. That's all for today. Thank you all for listening. Please stay tuned for our next episode. Like, share, and spread the word around you. For Christ and for the Church. God bless you all.